Nintendo seems like they're not going to make directs for a while. I think somebody reported that at one point too, although I don't really know how credible it was, but in any case, I would believe it. It doesn't seem like there are going to be Nintendo Directs anytime soon, and while part of that is almost definitely due to outside things, given some of the other stuff that Nintendo's been doing with announcements lately, I think it's fair to wonder about the future of Nintendo Directs and announcements in general. I mean, are we gonna have a lot of full direct style things, or will it switch to smaller, more on the spot announcements like we got with Paper Mario? Are we gonna get announcements with letters in the mail, faxed over to us, walkie-talkie style, carrier pigeon? You laugh now, but carrier pigeons are making a comeback. Hello all 2,400 of you, I'm Red Kwan, and what's the future of Nintendo Directs? So you're probably thinking, Red Kwan, what exactly are you doing here? Sure, Nintendo Directs aren't really a thing right now, but isn't all that just because nobody at Nintendo can do anything right now? And you know, maybe, but I think there's a little more to it. First of all, the Paper Mario the Origami King announcement was different than how Nintendo has revealed any of their other big games, and again, while I'm sure part of that is because of the current state of affairs, I don't think that's all of it. Nintendo's been giving us less and less time between their announcement for an upcoming Direct and the Direct itself over the past few years, to the point where now, sometimes it doesn't feel like there's even a day between hearing about it and it happening. And I think that's evidence that these big, event-like Directs are becoming less and less of a thing. The Directs are still happening, and they're still as long as before, but Nintendo's been giving us less time to think about them, and it seems like they've been more focused on getting their announcements out quickly. Maybe part of that is because Nintendo thinks giving us, like, a day is better for getting us excited for something, or maybe they think if they only give us a day, we won't be as disappointed when they show a bunch of indie games nobody cares about for 75% of it, which they do, like, every time now. Okay, Red Kwan, calm down, deep breaths, but I think in general, Nintendo is trying to move away from needing Directs for all their major announcements, and trying to get people to associate Directs less with big events, and more as just a time when we get an extra amount of announcements. I think they ideally want to be able to announce things whenever they want to, and they're trying to slowly move toward that a little bit. And also, it seems like we're getting major Directs less and less frequently. I actually thought this problem was a lot worse than it is, and I thought we used to get a Direct like every couple months, and then we got it like 4 times a year, and now it's down to like 3 times a year. But when you look at the actual dates on Wikipedia, it's actually been this way since like 2015. We've usually gotten a Spring Direct in February through April, the E3 Direct, and then a Direct in September. That's how it was in 2017, 18, and 19, with the exception being the Switch event, but that doesn't really count. It's actually been way more consistent than I thought it was. There have, of course, been other Direct-like things mixed in there, like game-specific Directs, or Direct Minis, or the late great Direct Micros, which were exactly 17 minutes long, apparently. Rest in peace, Direct Micro. But as for main Directs, we've gotten them pretty consistently 3 times a year during the Switch's life. And of course, this year it doesn't seem like we're going to get an E3-style Direct in the summer, and we didn't get any in the spring, so the cycle seems somewhat broken. To be fair, I think there's a very good chance the Direct Mini in March was supposed to be a full Direct originally before this all went down, and I'm sure Nintendo would have done something for E3 too if E3 was still happening. So I don't think the fact that the streak is broken necessarily should mean a whole lot, but I do think it's interesting that the streak has been broken, and I think Nintendo needing to rely on different ways of announcing games right now could still have an impact on how games work in the future. So what exactly does all this mean? Well, I think Nintendo is probably going to be straying away from Directs over time. I definitely don't think they're going away, at least not anytime soon, but I could see them being less of a focus. They may not be the only way Nintendo announces stuff anymore, and I think we've already started to see Nintendo announce their games and projects more spontaneously and in less structured ways. I think we might be in for more smaller Directs, more specialized Directs, and Directs with less time between the announcement and Direct itself, and probably more solo announcements too. I think Nintendo will still want all their big announcements to come in Directs, because Directs are the best way to make sure as many people as possible are watching, but after seeing that announcements outside of Directs, like Paper Mario, still work, they may not feel limited to them anymore. Also, I think Nintendo probably doesn't like that people rate Directs and talk about how some of them aren't very good. I mean, I don't think they care that much, but it's hard not to disappoint people with Directs. And not only do you have to have good announcements set up with good trailers and stuff, but you also have to make sure there are enough of them, and that the filler announcements aren't too much of it and aren't boring, and then you have to make sure that the whole package is enjoyable to watch. A lot more goes into it than making a single trailer, and people expect a lot more from it, which really balloons expectations. Honestly, I think a lot of this less focus on Direct stuff is already starting to happen, and it seems like Directs have already gone this way for a little while, so it's not like that amazing of a prediction if it continues to happen, but I'll take credit for it, of course. For me though, I hope big Directs are still a thing at least to some extent. They have their problems, sure, but I definitely prefer them over random announcements with no warning. I could definitely do without the filler though. I'm talking about big Directs as in Directs with big announcements, not Directs that are an hour long because they have to show 20 games I don't care about, you know what I mean? Yeah, you know what I mean. Well, I'm Red Kwan. What do you think the future of Nintendo Directs will be? Do you think I'm stupid for thinking they're going to become less of an event and less of a necessity for big announcements? Can we get a petition to bring back Direct Micros? 17 minutes is the ideal amount of time for announcements, and I think it's a shame we've gone away from that. Anyways, I'm Red Quan, thank you all for watching, and I'll hopefully see you all later. Goodbye.